In this lesson, we are going to learn optical isomers and enantiomers. Let's begin. What are optical isomers? The compounds, optically active compounds or chiral compounds, having same molecular formula, same structure formula, same physical and chemical properties, but compounds are non-superimposable. For the non-superimposability, compounds have different action to the plane of the polarized light. Those compounds are called optical isomers, and this phenomenon is known as optical isomerism. Let's see one example. Two hydroxypropanoic acid or simply lactic acid. Formula is CH3CHOHCOOH. This is 2-hydroxypropanoic acid or lactic acid. It has one chiral center, which is denoted by asterisk. 2 to the power n. N is number of chiral centers. So here 2 to the power 1, because this compound contains only one chiral center. Now we got 2. That means this compound has 2 optical isomers. One is CH3CHOHCOOH. In this compound, this is chiral center. This is one isomer. What is its another isomer? If we consider here a mirror facing this compound, then we will get another compound, that is CH3CHOHCOOH. These are looking alike because these compounds are mirror images of each other. What is the difference between these two compounds? Molecular formula same, structure formula same, but difference is when this compound is placed over this compound, then this compound will be non-superimposable to this compound. This is the difference, that is non-superimposability. And because of this non-superimposability, this compound rotates plane of the polarized light towards right clockwise. That is why its name is dextrorotatory or simply small d lactic acid, or plus lactic acid. This compound rotates the plane of the polarized light towards left, anti-clockwise direction. That is why its name is levorotatory or simply lowercase l lactic acid, or minus lactic acid. These two compounds are optical isomers. The compounds or chiral compounds, optically active compounds having same molecular formula, same structure formula, same physical and chemical properties, but difference is only one is non-superimposable to another one. And because of this non-superimposability, one compound rotates plane of the polarized light clockwise direction towards right, and another one rotates plane of the polarized light anti-clockwise direction towards left. That is why these compounds are optical isomers, and this phenomenon is known as optical isomerism. These two compounds are called enantiomers as well. Definition is when two compounds are mirror images of each other, then these two compounds rotate the plane of the polarized light to the equal amounts, but the direction is opposite. One rotates clockwise direction, another one rotates the plane of the polarized light anti-clockwise direction, but the value will be same. These two compounds are called enantiomers, and this phenomenon is known as enantiomerism. Here this compound rotates plane of the polarized light 2.24 degree angle, and this one rotates 2.2 degree as well, but it rotates clockwise direction. That is why this is plus. It rotates anti-clockwise direction. That is why this is minus. The matter is, the two compounds that rotates plane of the polarized light to the equal amounts, but in opposite direction. These two compounds are called enantiomers or enantiomorphs, antimers or antipodes. Let's see another example related to enantiomers. Enantiomers in detail. Let's take a compound, glucose. Molecular formula is CHO, CHOH, 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 and finally CH2OH. This is chain structure of glucose. Here there are four chiral centers. That is why it forms total 16 isomers. From these 16 isomers, let's try to write two isomers. One is CHO, CH2OH, 1, 2, 3, 4, HOH, 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 HOH. The farthest chiral center contains large group on the right side. That is why its name is uppercase D glucose. Let's write another isomer of glucose which is like mirror image of each other. CHO, CH2OH, 1, 2, 3, 4. HOH, 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 HOH. The farthest chiral center contains large group on its left side. That is why its name is L-glucose. These two are optically active compounds, chiral compounds, but this one rotates plane of the polarized light clockwise direction. That is why this is D or plus D glucose, and this one rotates plane of the polarized light anti-clockwise direction towards left. That is why its name is lowercase L glucose or we can say this is plus D glucose, this is minus D glucose. These two compounds rotate the plane of the polarized light to the equal amounts, but in opposite direction. That is why from these 16 isomers, these two isomers are called enantiomers of each other. This is enantiomer of this compound, and this is enantiomer of this compound. This phenomenon is known as enantiomerism. Enantiomers are formed when a mirror is considered between these two compounds, which are non-superimposable. This is all about optical isomers and enantiomers. Namo today. Thank you very much.